हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ अशोक बगड़ा फ्रॉम डॉक्टर सुभाष टेक्निकल कैंपस। एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट बैलेंसिंग ऑफ इंजन फ्रॉम द डायनेमिक्स ऑफ मशीनरी। सो लेट स्टार्ट। सो वी नो दैट इन अ वी इंजन और अ रेडियल इंजन, सो वी इंजन इज अ टू सिलेंडर रेडियल इंजन इन विच कनेक्टिंग रोड आर फिक्स टू अ कॉमन रैंक। इन अनदर वे वी कैन से दैट the center of cylinder, center line of cylinder form a V letter. So that's why it is also known as a V engine. In a V engine, suppose we consider this is a center line of cylinder 1, this is a center line of cylinder 2. So both form a V letter. So it is known as a V engine. In a V engine, the cylinder have a common crank and this crank revolve in a one plane. So there is no primary and secondary couple. So in a V engine, there is no presence of primary and secondary couple. So only primary and secondary forces are there. So let us consider some notation. M is the mass of reciprocating part. So let us consider a V engine. So here, this is a center line of cylinder 1. This is a center line of cylinder 2. And the angle between this, the center line of two cylinder is alpha plus alpha, that means 2 alpha. So 2 alpha is a V angle. This is a vertical axis and this is a horizontal axis. O is the center of rotation of crank and OC is a crank. So CP is connecting rod, one connecting rod which is connect crank with the piston of cylinder 1, and CQ is another connecting rod which connect crank and piston of cylinder 2. So let us consider some notation. M is the mass of reciprocating part per cylinder. That means M, we can say that M is the mass of piston. L is the length of connecting rod. So there are two connecting rods and both connecting rod having L length. Small r is the radius of crank. So there is a only one crank because both connecting rod are attached to a common crank. Small n is the obliquity ratio, is equal to L by R. Theta, crank angle measured from vertical axis OY. So here we assume this angle from the vertical line, crank make an angle theta degree. Omega is angular speed of crank and 2 alpha is a V angle. So we can say that angle between lines of stroke of cylinders. So we know that if we consider only this mechanism, that means crank, connecting rod and cylinder, then it is become a single cylinder engine. So we know that in a single cylinder engine, some primary unbalanced forces are acting and secondary unbalanced forces are acting. So primary force is Fp is m omega square r cos theta acting along the line of stroke, and similarly secondary forces is m omega square r cos 2 theta upon n. It is also acting along the line of stroke. But here we consider this one first, we analyze cylinder 1 and then we analyze for another mechanism. So here we have considered 2 alpha is a V angle. So if we imagine symmetric figure, then this center line, cylinder, center line of cylinder 1 make an angle alpha degree with vertical axis. Similarly, center line of cylinder 2 makes an angle alpha degree with vertical axis. Okay, now here the theta, this is, so whenever we have discussed about primary and secondary unbalanced forces, then theta, what is theta? So theta is a angle between crank and line of stroke, center line of cylinder, we can say that center line of cylinder. So here this is another theta. So theta is a angle between crank and center line of cylinder. So primary force is m omega square r cos theta and secondary force is m omega square r cos 2 theta upon small n. So we know that along the line of stroke there is a primary forces and secondary forces, but these forces are for a cylinder 1. So here we write fp1 and fs1. So fp1 is a primary forces in a cylinder 1. Fs1 is a secondary forces along the center line of cylinder 1. Similarly, Fp2 and Fs2 are primary and secondary unbalanced forces along the center line of cylinder 2. So this component Fp1 and Fs1 having also two component, horizontal component and vertical component. Similarly, Fs2 and Fp2 having also two component, horizontal component and vertical component. So let us resolve the component. So primary forces. So primary forces in individual cylinder. So if we consider primary forces for cylinder 1 is by notation 1, then Fp1 is a primary forces in cylinder 1. So we know that the equation of primary forces is m omega square r into cos and theta, but theta is the angle between crank and center line of cylinder 1. So here the angle, this is a crank and this is a center line of cylinder 1. So this angle is alpha minus theta. So this is total angle is alpha and this angle is theta. So the angle between crank and center line of cylinder is alpha minus theta. So here we put alpha minus theta. So primary Fp1, that means primary unbalanced force in a cylinder 1 is become m omega square r cos in bracket alpha minus theta. Similarly, primary unbalanced forces acting along the line of stroke of cylinder 2. So again Fp2, it is for cylinder 2. So m omega square r into cos. Now here we write a theta. So theta is nothing but it is a angle between crank and center line of cylinder. So if we consider cylinder 2, this is cylinder 2 and this is cranks and this is a theta. So theta become alpha plus theta. So here we write m omega square r into cos in bracket alpha plus theta. So here alpha plus theta is our angle between crank and line of stroke of cylinder 2. So now we obtain two equations. We have two equations. Fp1, it is a primary unbalanced force acting along the line of stroke of cylinder 1. Fp2, it is a primary unbalanced force acting along the line of stroke of cylinder 2. So total primary force along the vertical line. Now if we consider vertical, total primary force along the vertical line, that means this component having one vertical component and this component, this force having also one vertical component. So total, so we can say that Fp1 into cos alpha, this angle is alpha. So this force having two component, vertical and horizontal. So vertical component become Fp1 cos alpha again and Fp2 cos alpha. So here we rewrite primary force, the total vertical component of primary force. So Fpv is equal to Fpv cos alpha plus Fp2 cos alpha. So if you put the value of Fp1, then m Fp1 and Fp2, then m omega square r cos in bracket alpha minus theta into bracket complete into cos alpha plus m omega square r cos in bracket alpha plus theta into cos alpha. So if we expand, then we obtain cos alpha into cos theta minus sin alpha into sin theta. And here if we expand this equation, then cos alpha into cos theta minus sin alpha into sin theta. So again, if we take common, cos alpha is, we consider common, then we consider m omega square r into cos alpha, we obtain in bracket cos alpha minus theta plus cos alpha plus theta. If we expand these two equations, then here the cos alpha minus theta means cos alpha cos theta plus sin alpha sin theta. And here cos alpha plus theta means cos alpha into cos theta minus sin alpha sin theta. So in this case there is a plus sin alpha sin theta and here minus sin alpha sin theta. So that terms will be nullify. So only remains 2 times cos alpha into cos theta. So finally vertical component become Fpv is equal to 2 omega square r cos theta cos square theta. Here it is cos square theta into cos theta. Sorry. Vertical component Fpv is equal to 2m omega square into r cos square alpha into cos theta. So same way we Derived, we required total primary force along the horizontal line. Total primary force along the horizontal line. So this is force, and having one component is in this direction and one component is in this direction. So FP1 sine alpha. So FP1 sine alpha in this direction, and FP1 sine alpha, FP2 sine alpha in this direction. So here we write FP1, here we write FP1 sine alpha minus FP2 sine alpha. So put the value m omega square r cos alpha minus theta into sin alpha minus m omega square r cos alpha plus theta into sin alpha. So take a common. So m omega square r into sin alpha is common. So we obtain cos alpha minus cos theta minus cos alpha into sin alpha cos alpha in bracket alpha plus theta. If we again expand this equation, then the equation of cos alpha minus beta we use here. So cos alpha cos theta plus sin alpha sin theta minus cos alpha cos theta minus minus plus sin alpha sin theta. So here cos alpha cos theta will be nullify, so only remain 2 times alpha into sin theta. So we obtain vertical component is 2m omega square r sin square alpha into sin theta. Now we have two component, one is a vertical component, we have vertical component and horizontal component. So horizontal component is F, P, H, and here F, P, V. So we can obtain resultant. So resultant F, P, R is equal to under root F, P, V square plus F, P, H square. So if we put the value and if we simplify the equation, then we obtain F, P is equal to M omega square R under root in a bracket cos square alpha into cos theta bracket square plus in a bracket sin square alpha into sin theta bracket square. And if we want an angle made by the resultant with the vertical line, then beta p is tan inverse vertical component upon horizontal component. So we obtain, if we put the value, then we get beta p is tan inverse in a bracket tan square alpha into tan theta. Similarly, if we resolve vertical component and horizontal component of secondary forces, then we obtain an equation Fs is equal to 2 by n into m into omega square into r in under root in a bracket cos alpha into cos 2 alpha into cos 2 theta bracket whole square plus in a bracket sin alpha plus sin square sin 2 alpha into sin 2 theta whole square. And the angle with the vertical line we obtain beta s is tan inverse in a bracket tan alpha into tan 2 alpha into tan theta. So in a V engine we have derived primary unbalanced force and secondary unbalanced forces. Thank you.